Here we are going to understand how to create new static block and how to display block in different areas. In different areas means we are going to cover all these topics. Okay, we are going to display static block on the category pages. We are going to display a famous block with the help of widget. Okay, with the help of this editor as well. And if we want to display blocks with using layout XML files, that also we will discuss. And with the help of templates also, we can call the static blocks. So what is the way for it? That also we are going to cover. And if we want our static block to display in some other static block, so how to do that? That also we are going to cover in this video. So hit the like button and subscribe, so that you get notifications of my each video. Okay, let's go to our website. This is my home page. Okay, and this is my admin panel. So this is the dashboard, right? So to create a static block, we need to go to the content and then click on blocks. So here you will see the list of blocks which are there present in Magento system. So footer link blocks, contact us info, so these are all the blocks which are present in sample data, okay, of Magento 2 system. Let's see few blocks what content is there, so that we will get an idea that what content we can write in our block as well. Okay, so let's go to first footer link block. Okay, I'm opening it in new tab, and then we will see contact us info block as well. Yeah, then let's see one of the block. Let's say sell left menu block. Okay, so let's first open footer link block. Okay, what content is there? Let's see. So content is about us and customer service. So let's go to the site and let's see. Okay, so this is coming up from this block. Okay, so if you want to add some link, you can definitely click hit enter and write some link and save. So that will solve our purpose. Isn't it very easy? We don't need to go to the code to write this block, right? To write content in the website. Okay, so we just added some content here, saved it, and it will display here. Amazing, right? So we clear with this block. Next, let's see the contact us info. So this block has this kind of content. Okay, so where is this block coming up and where is this block displaying? Okay, so this block, let's see to contact us module. Yeah, so can you see the content below here from you? Yeah, so up to this part is coming up from contact us block. So in this way, we can create our own block. So to create our own block, we need to click on add new link button, sorry, add new block button. And here, I want to display this block enabled, I mean, after creation. Okay, so I just keep it, yes, give block title, my first block, give some identifier. This should be the unique identifier, means unique ID to the block, so that we can call this block with the help of this ID. Okay, so write some content. For example, this is my first block. So stop. Okay, if you are comfortable in HTML code, you just need to click here and you can write some HTML code and you can save after that. Okay, so this is my first block. Let me just make it bold. You can give here headings as well. Okay, I'm sure you must be familiar with this. So in the center, no bullets, no numbering I want. I'll insert some link, maybe this link is fine to me. I just put it here. Okay, and you can insert table also. Okay, so for example, this table 1, 2 video first, video second. So you can write the content as per your requirement. You can you know, go to the properties and can give width and height. Okay, like this. So you can modify the content as per your requirement, and then you can insert special characters. You can insert image as well. Let's go to the So this is all table, right? Okay. So before table, this is my first block to stop, and this is bold, middle, insert some link. This link I prefer put it there. You can open it in new page also, new window, or you can give some title as well. You can insert image. Okay, so where to insert? Just put the cursor over there. Okay. And click on image, and you can give here select or upload the image which you want to display on our site or on this static block. So you can choose from here by clicking on this, or you can select from here. Okay, so let me go to the home. I'm fine with this static block. Then after click on add selected. Once you click on that, it gives you an option to add some description or image height and width. I'm okay with it. Okay, so I just clicked on the image. Yeah, so it is appearing here. Okay, so I just want to make this table in the center as well. Oops, the content is there. Yeah, center. Okay, image also in the center. Okay, so what options we have? Save and continue, and save and close. Okay, so once you save and close, this page will close. If you click on save and continue, this block will be saved and new block will be created with the same content. Okay, and if you click on save, it will be saved. So it is putting you here itself. Okay, so if the blocker is already present, you can see this kind of error that, you know, it's already present. Block identifier with the same properties already exists, so you can give some other name. Clear? So this will save our static block. Yes, our static block is ready with the content. Now, where are we going to display this static block? So, depending upon your requirement, you can decide what approach you want to follow. Okay? So, if you want to display the blocks on the category pages, then there is a specific way to do it. Okay? The same with the widgets and with the editor, and there is a way to add CMS block also with the layout, okay, and template. So first we'll talk about category page. Okay, so let's go to one of the category. Let's see the woman. Okay, and in the woman category, I want to display static block. So let's further go to the categories by going into catalog and then categories. Select the category where you want to display the static block. Go to the content and here add CMS block. Add CMS block. You can select the content, the block which you want to appear there. Okay. And then display setting. So if you want to display static block, you need to have one of the mode, okay, either static block only or static blocks and products. Okay, so the woman category was having static block only, so I put it here itself. And add CMS block, I selected the block which I want to display there. Okay, then click on save. So once you saved, you need to clear the cache here. Once cache is cleared, yeah. So we will go to here category pages, and we can see our static block will appear. This is content, right? This is our first block, this is that. So yeah, can you see our static block displaying here? Perfectly awesome. So in this way we can display static block in the category.
Now we will see how we can display static block with the help of widgets. Okay, so to do that we need to go to Magento dashboard, then click on content and then go to the widgets. So this is the list of widgets, and here these all widgets has been created using the sample data of Magento 2. Okay, so you can see these all widgets are static blocks. Okay, so let's see what kind of information they have. Okay, so let's click on one of the widgets. Okay, so let's click on women category content. So here you can see the type static block, then we need to select the theme, and then we need to give the title and the store where we want to assign it, and then order, and then display on anchor categories. Okay, so if you don't know what are the anchor categories, you can go into the description. Okay, so there I will, you can see the list link of categories management video which is of mine. You can go and understand the details about it. Okay, so that video has everything related to categories. Okay, now the specific categories they have used, and then main content top. Okay, so let's go to the we'll see it, but let me see first options. Okay, so woman block is the title of the static block. Okay, so this static block has been assigned and has been given to the categories with the help of this widget. Okay, so let's go to the woman and let's see what content is there in this static block. So for the static block, click on this. I opened it in a new tab and let's see woman block. Yeah, here you can see woman block. So let me see the content. Okay, so these are the contents. Okay, yeah, can you see it? Yeah, here it is. Yeah, so this all content has been added from there. Okay, and you can see in the static block we they have, you know, presented some product list as well. Okay, so this is also possible. Okay, so in the static block we can add this kind of features as well. So this is amazing functionality which Magento has given to us. Okay, so we place the static block with the help of widgets on the anchor categories. Okay, and the content area where it will be displayed is the main content top. Okay, so in this way with the help of widgets we can display the static blocks. So if you want to see how we can do it, so let me just see if we can add some our static block. Okay, this block here in this area, let's see if we can do it. Okay, let's go to the cell and yeah, here is this block. Let me see if we can do it. Okay, so to do that, okay, click on add widget. So this this will appear, and here we will select CMS static block and design theme is Luna theme. Click on continue, and once you click we can give some title here, for example this. Okay, then you can see, so my sidebar widget block. So when you are giving title, it should be so clear that from name itself it should tell you what exactly it's for. Okay, so I want it for all stores, and then sorter I don't care about. Okay, display on say for example all pages. Okay, so I want the static block to appear on all pages, and the container will be for example let's say sidebar additional column will be added there. Okay, okay, so all sounds good. And then widget option, I need to select here my static block. So see for example, so this block which I created, I want to display there. Okay, click on save. Once we will save it, we need to clear the cache. So let me just complete. Yeah, it's done, it's saving. Awesome, let me refresh the cache. Awesome, let's see in the front end now. So I'm in the cell category, I'm just refreshing the page, and where static block should appear here somewhere, okay, in this area. So let me just see. Yeah, awesome, right? So this is our static block which is appearing here in the sidebar, and this we done with the help of widgets. Awesome. Let's see now how we can display static block with the help of this editor. Okay, good. So where we will display? Let's go to maybe about us page. Let's see. Okay, so this is about us page, and we want to display our static block in this page. Let's go to content and then pages. So here about us page. Let me just edit this content. Okay, where we will display? We will display here just below. Okay, shop Puma. Okay, so go to the content, and here you can see shop Puma. Let's hit enter. So put the cursor where you want to display that static block. Okay, so let me just go to insert. Okay, so this is the editor. Let me just go back a little. Okay, so this is the editor, and in this, with the help of this editor, we are going to add static block. So this is the way. You need to click here, insert widget. And here we will select the type, and then we will select the template. Okay, and here I will choose my static block. Okay, then selected, and very simple, just click on insert widget and you will be able to see it now. Okay, so CMS static block has been added. Now save this, and you should able to see now your static block on this about us page. But before that, we need to clear the cache. So once you save the configuration, refresh this page, clear the cache, and then refresh this page. Yeah, so this is the way we can of course, this maybe some CSS is disabling the table border, etc., but we don't need. You can use your CSS and you can work on this. So main point is, we are able to display here our static block on this page. Amazing. So in this way, we learned till now about the category page, about the widgets, and with the help of editor also, we are able to display static blocks. So now we are going to understand how to display static block with the help of layout XML files. Okay, so let's go to our home page. Okay, so for example, I want to display my static block in one of the custom module, we can say. Okay, so this is my custom module. Okay, so my module, I clicked on this link. You can see this content is just displaying from HTML file. Nothing big is done in this module, is under progress. Okay, so I want my static block to appear here. So how to do that? I need to go to layout file of this module. Okay, so my module index refers to this, right? So let's go to this module. So app code, the coach assembly, my module, go to view, front end, layout, and then my module index. Okay, so you can see here some code is already present. What code do I need to add there? I need to add this code. Okay, reference container name content, is this present? Yes, the content is already there. Okay, so I'm just copying this block content there. If it is not present, okay, this reference container content is not present, then you need to copy the whole code. If it is present, just copy this block code. Okay, copied it, and then just paste it before this reference container ends. Paste it, right? Good. Okay, so what code do I need to update here? I just need to update my identifier. Okay, the static block which I want to display, its identifier. I will just copy and paste it here in both the case, in the block name as well and in the argument. Okay, saved. So this is block ID saved. I need to clear the cache once. So cache has been cleared. Now let's go to our custom module. Let's refresh this page. Have you noticed the static blocks which we added in the sidebar? And that is on all the pages. So it's appearing on my custom modules as well. Isn't it amazing? Magento has given us so many features already built in it. Just we need to understand and follow the Magento's way to organize our code and to, you know, make everything work properly. Yeah, so we just refresh this page and you can see our static block appears here now, right? So with the small code we are able to do that, right? So this we saw about layout XML. Now let's understand what we can do with the template files. Is it possible to call static blocks in the template files? The answer is yes. How to do that? Just copy this code, okay, paste it in its proper HTML file, okay, PHTML file. So, okay, so this is view.phtml file. I just pasted this code. We need to write it in PHP tag. Okay, so this code I just pasted. Need to copy the identifier of my static block and paste it here in set block ID. Save the file. Okay, so it's my same module, right? It's my same module, and it's in this module's PHTML file I'm calling it. But we call this also in the layout, right? With the help of layout, so it should appear two times. Save the files, clearing the cache, and this is through the layout, right? So let me just refresh and it should show two static blocks of the same, right? So this is for layout and the other one will be from the template. Yeah, awesome. These two, cool. So last thing, and that is to display block within the block. Okay, so static block within another static block. So let me just copy this. Okay, and this is the static block, and in the static block, okay, just call some other static block. Yeah, can you see here? So what I'm trying to do is, in the contact us form, okay, so let's go to the woman category, and here we will call the contact us block in our static block. Okay, let's do that. So let's go to the content and then blocks. Okay, so contact us info is the identifier. Okay, copy it and just copy this code. Will it work? So block class, this class name, okay, and then block ID, the identifier of another static block. So this is what I'm doing. Click on the save. Once saved, clear the cache. Oops, okay, let me do it again. Okay, so let me just edit. Copy and save. His session was out, okay, that's the reason. Okay, I got this just now. Okay, so this is what we have written. We saved. Now clear the cache once. Yeah, done. Now refresh this page. What we will be able to see? The content of the contact us info block in our static block. Awesome. Can you see it? This is the static block of contact us info, and that we are able to add in our static block. Amazing. So in this way, we are able to understand how to create static blocks in Magento 2 system and how to display the static block in these different areas. So if you like this video, do hit the like button and click on the subscribe button, because I am preparing this video just to share my knowledge with you so that you people will easily able to understand on Magento system. So if you want to see more videos of mine, you need to hit on the subscribe and the notification icon so that you will be get notified once I upload my videos. So thank you so much for watching, and do comment below mentioning the topics on which you want the videos on, and do give us feedback.